Even as the Maharashtra police is cracking down on an alleged urban Maoist nexus responsible for the violence in Bhima Koregaon, Sport, which is in Times Now's possession, blames Hindutva activists led by Sambhaji Bhide and Milind Ekbote.
Clearly, this report says that Milind Ekbote and Sambhaji Bhide, the Hindutva leaders, are responsible for this, because this is something which was a well-planned conspiracy. That's exactly what this report, in fact, is mentioning. Apart from that, the report also says that this was planned much before before January 1st, when the incident, in fact, took place. There were certain swords and also arms which were made ready before the violence, before January 1st. And in fact, the locals there even knew that something like this is going to happen. But clearly, the police had taken a complete blind eye to this, and which is why the situation only escalated and got worse. We know one person was also killed in that.
On 3rd January 2018, an FIR was filed against Mr. Bhide and others. And this is the first FIR, which says that Mr. Bhide and his colleagues were involved in generating violence, generating communal speech, generating casteist speech, which led to the violence which happened on 1st and 2nd. Mr. Ekbote, who was the accused, files a case for anticipatory bail. This case goes up to Supreme Court. A state government files an affidavit in the Supreme Court. In February 2018, it is the prosecution's case that during investigation, it revealed that the petitioner, that is Milind Ekbote, had actively participated in criminal conspiracy to execute the offence. And therefore, the name of petitioner came to be inserted in the present offence. And he says that Ekbote and others are involved in attempt to commit murder, provocative speeches, etc. This is what they say.
Obviously, this one can call it a conspiracy by the Pune police to unfold this entire picture of diverting the attention from who were the actual perpetrators. 8th of January was the first FIR against the organizers of the Elgar petition, which is CR 4 of 2018, in which there is no UAPA, in which there is nothing except 153, which is trying to create enmity between communities. In that FIR, there were 6 accused names. Today, of the 10 people arrested, there is only one, Sudhir Dhawale, who has been arrested out of that FIR. In the month of April, there were raids in the houses of these 6 accused, and in addition to 2 more people, Surendra Gadling in Pune, in Nagpur, and Rona Wilson in Delhi. It is at that time that everyone's antenna started working, that something more sinister is afoot.
Residents and offices are raided by Pune police. Recent raids are conducted at their houses because Pune police is fearing that allegedly they are urban Maoists, and those people are also involved in those speeches which were given one day prior to Bhima Koregaon victory march.
None of the persons, barring one or so, of the persons arrested now or earlier, were present at Bhima Koregaon, and admittedly so. None of them sent Skype messages to Bhima Koregaon. None of them were on video conferencing as far as the Elgar Parishad are concerned. Despite that, in an FIR which only deals with provocative speeches, all these persons have been arrested. And they have been arrested not under normal law.
Then before you know it, on one day, these raids are carried out. When you have a dispensation like we have today, armed with a law like the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, just about anything goes. All one could do in this helpless manner was ask questions to these people who came to the house. They were there for 6 hours, from 6 in the morning to 1:45 when Vernon was taken away. I asked, did you even spend 6 minutes inside the houses of Sambhaji Bide and Egbote? So one of the persons said, Varun Adesh Alatar Ami Tabartok Karmar. Letter after letter being talked about some Naxal plot, some Maoist, some. In what way is all this connected to the Bhima Koregaon Elgar Parishad? Justice Golse Party, Justice P.B. Sawar, they are crying themselves hoarse, saying that we are the organizers. The Pune police do little and nothing and go on harping. So this is the Gobelinian propaganda.
So I had a meeting in Bharat Petroleum and kept my phone on silent. By the time meeting was over and I switched on phone, there were spate mess calls from everywhere, but many of them from my wife. So I just called her back and she said that everything is coming on TV, our house is open. I was shocked.
The crackdown by Pune police continues. It is not going to end. Now there are some more people who the Pune police is now looking for, and the latest being Professor Anand Teltumle.
Press conference conducted by Parambir Singh, Additional Director General of Police in Pune. He rather read out a letter that related with the Paris conference, supposedly addressed to me by someone who is purportedly Maoist. The letter effectively said that okay, that we have arranged for your meeting in Paris. Comrade ATN Balibar also agreed to interview you. Comrade Shailaja Paik and Comrade Anupama Rao call you for guest lectures in their universities. This is the university, the American University of Paris. For an academic conference, even if you go and approach or sort of lobby around that, oh, you please call him, that is not possible. But this is the kind of level they stoop to. I had an ammunition because I sent that letter. I got it from journalist friend and sent it across to university. Lisa Lincoln, Professor Lisa Lincoln, who was the main organizer of the conference, and ATN Balibar, and both these fellows, Paik and Anupama Rao. They were aghast at this kind of fabrication, and Lisa Lincoln forwarded the letter to provost complaining that such and such is happening by the police in India. I thought that my case, if it lands up in the court, there would be havoc because the entire construction would fall flat. Incontrovertibly actually proves that it is a fabrication. That letter itself, one letter is enough, that everything is fabrication.
Because in the middle of this coronavirus outbreak, when courts after courts actually releasing people on bail today, Dalit activist and scholar Anand Teltumble was arrested by the anti-terror agency, the NIA, in Mumbai after he surrendered, after court refused to grant him bail and Supreme Court relief had ended. Saurabh has more details on that. Saurabh, what's the controversy about this arrest? We've seen also the open letter that Mr. Teltumble has written today. Tell us the key points.
One of the key points of Anand Teltumble's letter is that, you know, I don't know when I'll be able to talk to you next, but don't keep quiet until it's your turn.
I call it the use of UAPA because UAPA, the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, is meant for this purpose. It is not being misused, it is being used for the purpose for which it was brought in, which is basically to keep behind people behind bars for long periods without having any proof, without any evidence, because you can't apply for anticipated bail, you can't apply for regular bail for a long time. So you slap UAPA on anybody and everybody?
Oh, they are not interested in investigation because this UAPA provisions are such that you can just use them and create that kind of fog in a judge's mind, and they can keep on giving that kind of judgment because there's no provision, explicit provision for bail. Now, historically speaking, if you verify the data, all these UAPA cases on an average land up something like 5-6 years incarceration in jail, and thereafter they ended in acquittals.